Hi everyone, welcome back to GA Online Teaching, and we are busy with part 4 of Geometry of Straight Lines, still busy with fun angles, and we're going to incorporate all three rules together. Right? As far as possible, I'm only going to try and use the fun angles. Okay, so over here I have a diagram. Please pause this video. Make sure that you can do it by yourself, and let's see if our answers correlate. Also, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to GA Online Teaching. Alright, so remember we are going to do this in alphabetical order. So there's A, there's B, there's C, D, E, and F. Notice the lines going across my horizontal lines. They are parallel, those two. And the third one over there. And the ones going up, those are also parallel. Notice when they are parallel, you're going to use your fun angles over there. So first, let's look at A. Because those two lines are parallel, that's my transversal, meaning A would be what? Exactly the same to 22. Why? Because of alternate angles. So A will be equal to 22 alternate angles, right? And if you get your question paper, make sure that you write 22 in your diagram so that you know what's going on. Right, so B over there. Now notice B is on this angle, right? What do I notice over there? That B and A are 90 degrees. In other words, they are complementary. What tells me that it is 90 degrees? That little square over there. And that is 90. So if I have A, I don't have B. All I have to say, A, which is 22, plus what will give me 90? It's basically equal to 68 degrees. And your reason over there will be complementary angles equal to 90 degrees. All right, so A is 22, let's write it out. B is equal to 68. All right, what about C? Notice those lines are parallel and I have my transversal. What letters does that make? An upside down U, meaning that the two angles that are inside of my parallel lines. And what does inside mean? Interior. 2 means co, so co-interior angles add up to 180 degrees. So therefore, 180 minus 68 is 112 degrees. Co-interior angles equal 180 degrees. So that is 112. And the next one, D, is very, very simple. D is also 112 degrees because of vertically opposite angles that are equal. So D, 112 vertically opposite angles are equal. Right. Let's go over now to what comes after D, E. Now notice these lines over there, they are parallel to one another. And what letter do I see? That's my transversal. I notice that B and E, they are corresponding to one another. And corresponding angles is what? That they are equal to each other. So E would be corresponding to B. Therefore, E is equal to 68. Corresponding angles are equal. And I write it down. 68. And then F, right? So F is different ways. So the first one I can say are vertically opposite will always be the easiest. But because I'm busy with fun, I'm going to use that B, that's a Z, and F are alternate to one another. And what does alternate mean? That the angles are the same. So F is also equal to 68 degrees. Because alternate angles are equal, right? Pause that video. There are many different ways of getting to the same answer. I only focused on your fun angles part. Okay, learners, on to example number 2. So the lines going across, they are parallel. The lines going sideways, they are also parallel. All right, so when I see parallel lines, I think of fun angles, okay? pause the video, and again, make sure that our answers will be the same. Right, as far as possible, I'm going to try and use the fine angles. All right, so let's look at A over there. I have 123, so again, alphabetical order. Notice the lines going across. I have my transversal. So what can you tell me is the relationship between 123 and A? That the two both lie on the inside of my set of parallel lines, therefore they are co-interior. And what does co-interior mean? That they add up to 180 degrees. So 180 minus 123 is equal to 57 degrees. And it will say co-interior angles equal to 180 degrees. Then I write the name, 57. Now notice if I look at B and A, what is the relationship between? I see the letter Z over there, meaning that they are the same, they are alternate to one another. So therefore B is also equal to 57. Another way of mentioning that is that B and 123 lie on a straight line. Okay, so I will just use the alternate angles are equal, or just alternate angles, right? 57. All right, what about C over there? Now look at C. The easiest one is vertically opposite. Then I can also use a straight line, or if I look at A and C, they both lie on top of my parallel lines, meaning that they are corresponding. And if I go back to my lesson a few weeks ago, corresponding means what? The same, but at a different position. So therefore C is also equal to 57 degrees. Corresponding angles are equal. You can write any reason. The memo will have all the different types of reasons. You just need to choose one. So C is equal to 57. Right. And so I have angle D over there. Right. Now what can you tell me about D? D is equal to 123 degrees. Yes, that's perfect. Right. Let's look at the reason. D is on the right hand side of my parallel line. 123 is on the right hand side of my parallel line. So therefore they are corresponding angles. Another way of looking at it, these lines are parallel, meaning B and D are also co-interior. You just write one reason down. Okay, I will use corresponding angles. All right, so that is equal to 123. All right, then I look at E. Now the easiest way to find that E is equal to 86 degrees. 37, E, and angle A, they lie on a straight line, so therefore I can just say 180 minus 57 minus 37 is equal to 86 degrees. Now, the reason is what is important. You can write straight line, yes. But remember, I'm busy with fun angles, so I'm going to use that reason. Now, notice these two angles over there and B, they lie inside of this parallel line, meaning that they are co-interior to one another. Again, what does co-interior mean? They add up to 180 degrees. So therefore, I can say 180 minus 57 minus 37 is still going to give me 86 degrees. I'm going to use the reason of co-interior angles equal to 180 degrees. And the last one over there is angle F. All right, angle F and 37, what's the relationship between the two? They are equal, but what's my reason? Alternate. There's a parallel, there's a parallel. That transversal over there makes the letter Z. So therefore, angle F is equal to 37 degrees, and my reason is alternate angles are equal. With that being said, lads, I went through it very, very slowly. Please pause the video, make sure that you understand it, because you're going to use this in grade 8, 9, 10, as well as grade 11 and 12. Please make sure that you subscribe. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to GA Online Teaching. And until next time.